Hello. Hi. Hi, everyone. How are you? TGIF, huh? Are you having a good day? A good week? Well, I am very, very excited that you're all joining us. We're going to speak to Yvanna Cancela. I think is how you pronounce her last name, or Cancela, to talk about the 59th presidential inauguration. And she's going to fill us in on what we can expect. And I'm very excited. I love a good inauguration. Who doesn't? And I'm glad you're here with us and joining us today. And I see you all. Thank you for loving me. I love you too. I'm glad you like Charmed. Hi. Hello. Oh, thank you for all you do. And I am going to see if Yvanna is with us yet. Let's see. See all. Ooh, we have a lot of people here. Hello, hello. I don't know if I see you yet, Yvanna. Let's see. I think Biden inaugural will be the account that we'll be requesting. Let's see if I can request Biden. Inaugural. Did I just spell that right? Return? Nope. Is this the worst part of Instagram Live or what? I'm looking for you, Yvanna. Where are you? Okay, let's see. Anyone? Let's see. At Biden inaugural. It's not even saying that that's an Instagram account. Huh. I don't know what's happening. Let's see. Colin, Sandra. Hi, everyone. Rick, Sarah, Ethan, Bruna, Michael, Christina, Mohammed, Ava. I see you all. I do not see Yvanna. So, let's see if I can get some help here. Let's see. So tell me more. How's life, everyone? I don't see their request. Oh, they're running 5 minutes late. We're trying to get Yvanna logged on the official Biden inaugural account. Okay, well, in the interim, hold on, let me just say, I am going to go live with one of you. How does that sound? Let's go live. Who's the lucky person? Gonna go live. Let's go live with Thomas. Thomas? Where are you, Thomas? Cancel. Thomas, you took too long. You snooze, you lose. Let's see who else. Mildred. Let's do it, Mildred. Oh, we're connecting with... Hi, Mildred!
Really? Oh my God, this is unbelievable. Hello, Melissa. Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Actually going to bed now. I'm in Norway.
Oh, this is goodness. Just a miracle. Norway?
Yes, actually, yes.
How is Norway? I've never been to Norway.
Well, then you maybe should come with all your family because it's
okay,
a beautiful place, it's peaceful.
Can we all stay at your house?
Well, why not? Of course. By the way, before we continue, I love your jacket.
Oh, thank you. I don't even know who this jacket is, but if you can see the tag.
No, it was very ethnical. I love it. I love it.
Thank you. I love your t-shirt.
It's my pajamas, actually.
I love it.
So first of all, I would like to congratulate you because of all the work that you have done before the elections and everything. Believe me, the whole world have been following everything about the madness in your country. Unfortunately, it does affect the whole world. And I want you to congratulate you with the... Well, wise election, finally. And I know, I have been following you, and I know that you have been very active, and I love it. We need more people like you, who knows what they are doing and is encouraging people to think by themselves instead of just, you know, absorb everything that the media is trying to manipulate. And that's something that I respect. So I am so happy. This is a miracle that I can express this to you.
Thank you so much for expressing it. And, you know, when you're fighting for something, you don't know if people, and especially, you know, it's the way social media is, I get a lot of hate, you know? And so to hear someone say something, like that, and someone who's not even in this country, it means so much to me because I think all any of us wanna be is seen, right? Seen for who we are and seen for the work that we put in, and so I appreciate that. Thank you. It really means a lot to me.
I really want you, honestly. Believe me, there are countries in the world where the kind of home that you want in the States is possible. And we are living that dream. I mean, I have a lot of relatives in the United States. I am grateful that my parents choose another country for me to grow up with in because of the whole situation. And I have been in the States a couple of times. And to be honest, the difference is huge before 9/11 and after that. As a foreigner, as a visitor, as a tourist, it has been very, very, very different to visit your country before and after.
Yeah, and I think that the thing that we have to keep fighting for is, you know, the ideal of what we know this country can be.
Exactly.
And for me, that means we have to start taking care of the citizens of this country. We have to put food on tables. We have to give people a living wage. Too many people are struggling right now.
Yes, with the basics, you know,
for the basics.
Total basics. Yes, I know.
For the
I
basics,
know.
Like healthcare. Yes.
If you get me started on that, you will not finish. I work.
So it's been really hard, but I think, you know, we all believe that, you know, the people that stay and fight really believe in the ideal of what this country could be. And we will continue to fight for that and ensure the people of this country get what they deserve, to be able to just dream and hope for a brighter tomorrow. That's all I want, is for people to not struggle so much anymore. And for people without struggle, it means you can hope and dream. And I think that's so, so very important. So this just made my day. I'm so glad they weren't logged on. thank you for this, and thank you for seeing me, and I see you too, and I appreciate you.
Oh my God, you can't imagine. I have been following you since you were on this, what was the show of the 80s when you played the daughter of
Who's the Boss?
Yeah, Who's the Boss? Yes. I even think I wrote a fan mail or something, you know, handwritten and everything. So talking to you now, but today is special, you know, because of all the chaos and everything in the political issue that the whole world has been following. And I am just so grateful that people like you, because I know that you're not alone, are really fighting. I cannot even imagine how it is to fight for something that should be just obvious for everybody. And that's
an exercise in futility, for sure.
Yes.
And now it's just felt like we're just fighting to get to not have things rolled back. We're not. We haven't even been fighting for progress, because we know that's been impossible. We've been fighting for rights to not be rolled back. So I'm really looking forward to a time when we can fight for progress again. You know, and so I see the work not over. This isn't the end of the hard work. This is the beginning of the hard work.
This is the beginning.
To know that you're on my side is really incredible. So thank
and
you.
I am not alone when it comes to that. I trust me on that one. Because we are many outside of the United States that even if we don't have any kind of connection with the country itself, to see the madness that has been, I couldn't even...
you're right. What happens in this country affects the entire world.
Yeah, unfortunately, it does. Yes,
yeah.
It does.
And so I get it. And so just know that I'm going to keep fighting. And I really appreciate this. And stay on before you go to sleep so you can hear all about the inauguration.
Yes, I will.
Okay.
Have a nice weekend. Bye-bye.
Thank you for this. You made my day. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye, darling. Oh, well, that was special. Okay, let's see. I'm hearing rumors that Yvanna is ready to go. So let's see. There we go. Here we go. Are you here?
Hi!
I'm so sorry that was all crazy.
Well, I'm a terrible millennial, and when it comes to technology, I fail more than I succeed. So my apologies.
Listen, I don't know what happens, but you just reach a certain age where technology is hard. My 9-year-old is like, "Oh, Mom, just let me do it." and I can see, like, even just my mobility around technology has been, I don't know, affected. I don't know what happens.
Yeah.
It's like, I was really good at this, you know, many, many years ago. And now it's like, wait, how do I even, is it this button? It's so bad. But I'm glad to see you.
Well, thank you for spending
some time with me.
Conversation. That was so special. That was great.
That was so special. I know. And I feel like maybe it was meant to happen. So I'm glad that, you know, you couldn't get logged on. I'm glad that you're a millennial with no technological, savviness.
Yes.
Yes. How are you?
I'm okay. I'm really, really excited about the next 5 days. And just the thought that on January 21st, we're going to wake up and be able to call Joe Biden president and Kamala Harris vice president. It's been what I've been working on for the last year and a half, and to now be a part of the inaugural team has been awesome. So everyone's working.
Tell me all about it. I mean, tell me is there one thing that you're most excited about?
That moment when Joe Biden has his hand on the Bible and takes the oath of office, I think is going to be really, really, really special for a lot of reasons, not just because it's Joe Biden taking office, but because that peaceful transition of power, that moment is such a bedrock of our democracy. So I'm really looking forward to that.
And that moment is always so incredibly special. I mean, one of my great, great memories of presidents being sworn in was the first time Barack Obama, for his first term, was sworn in. And I remembered being so upset because I was traveling that day. And so I had to be at the airport and I was like, what? I don't know how I'm going to watch this. I tell you, the entire airport stopped and everyone was looking at the terminal TVs and they played it on all the TVs and all the terminals. And it was just such a special, incredible moment. And I think I'm very excited about the inauguration, but I want everyone to remember something that I think is getting lost in all of this, which is we're swearing in a woman for the first time and a woman of color. This is such a huge historic moment for our country. So to be able to be alive during this time, and it's gonna be really interesting, I think, and tell me what you think, to see what impact Kamala Harris being vice president has on future generations of young women and young men as well. To see a woman in that position of that power, I think, is going to affect both our little girls and our little boys.
Well, even in, this is a small thing, but it's actually kind of a big thing. Just getting used to typing out she and her and female pronouns when talking about the vice president. Every time that I catch myself messing up and inserting a male pronoun instead of a woman pronoun, it's like a small reminder that we have broken a glass ceiling, that we have made a tremendous historic leap for our country. And it's special. It's really special that everyone will have to make that adjustment, not only because she is so qualified and excellent and so prepared to be our vice president, but because we are reaching this moment where a woman will hold one of the highest offices in our country. And it's remarkable. Really, really remarkable.
Yeah. And we're not conditioned to sort of live in that.
That's
right.
Do you
know what I mean? Like, and that's why we have to retrain ourselves when we talk about, and also just the second gentleman, her
yes.
husband,
yes.
who is, I don't think there's anyone more adorable. The way in which he supports her is so remarkable, but also just to like recognize how we're going to have to shift that mentality of like, are we going to look at Doug and say, ooh, that suit he was wearing, you know, like we always set such high standards for first and second ladies.
Right.
So it'll be interesting to see where do you plan on watching the inauguration? And just tell everybody, what will be different this year as far as, safety and security and all of that.
Yeah, the inauguration, from the moment we came together as a team, we knew it was going to look different. We are in the midst of a pandemic, and that means that keeping people safe is priority number one. And from the onset, it was clear that the footprint we would have in DC would be much smaller than it's been in years past. The historic image of hundreds of thousands of people coming to DC and standing with their flag on the mall in January, that was not going to be a part of this inauguration. But it did not mean that this inauguration would not be incredibly special. So we have themed the inaugural events America United, and it's really a celebration of everyday Americans, the heroic acts they have done over the last year as we have coped with the pandemic together. And you'll see that play out in a couple of ways. On January 20th, there will be a parade across America following the swearing-in ceremonies. And the parade will highlight and celebrate everyday Americans across all of the U.S. We've been able to work with the same folks who produced the incredible Democratic Convention to bring out the imagination and creativity of the country and really highlight that. And in the evening, you'll see a program that will similarly celebrate America, but will be laced with all sorts of talent and celebrities. And it's awesome because you can watch it from the comfort of your own home. So if you want to put on a ball gown and hang out with Justin Timberlake as he sings, you can do that. If you want to do it in your pajamas with a nice, maybe hot tea or a glass of wine, you can do that too.
It or, is a, truly, or a pint of ice cream.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And so it's going to be a day full of events that really highlights how special our country is and how special this moment is. And leading up to the inauguration, we'll have a series of events that will also bring us together in celebration. We are hosting a We the People concert on January 17th. We are hosting a COVID memorial. Imagine that we have lost close to 400,000 Americans, but have not taken a moment to honor those lives. We will do that on January 19th at 5:30 p.m. as a country. We'll have cities and states participate in that memorial. And so there's a number of things happening, and it's all online at BidenInaugural.org. If you go to the site, our schedule of events is live, and where to watch is all live.
Amazing. And I also just want to mention that Monday is the National Day of Service.
That's right. That's right.
And that's really important. And we encourage everyone that's watching to take part in serving your community. And I think the most important thing in the world is that we get back to leadership in a place of service and love and heart. And so what are you going to do for Monday?
So I'm right now out of my hometown. I live in Las Vegas, but I'm in Miami with my family. And it just so happens that volunteers from across the country have put together virtual and safe in-person events. There's an event here where folks are collecting canned food, so I'll be dropping some off. And if folks go to BidenInaugural.org, right up top, there's Day of Service. You can find events happening in your area. We have hundreds of volunteers putting events together, and it's such a special way to honor Dr. King's legacy by making it a day of action and a day of service. And there is such need in our communities.
It is such a perfect way to honor Martin Luther King Jr. and everything that he stood for and fought for. And that fight still continues to this day. Well, I'm really excited and I can't wait. And I thank you so much for hanging in there and getting logged on with me.
Thank you.
And tell everybody about where they should go right now to get more information.
Best place is BidenInaugural.org. And if you're not following our Biden Inaugural account here on Instagram, make sure you do. We're also on Twitter at Biden Inaugural, and we keep all of our information updated, and it's going to be a really wonderful set of events. We look forward to sharing it with you all.
Well, I look forward to celebrating with everyone as well. I'll be watching from home with hopes that I can watch it with some of my followers and fans. And so it's going to be special. I'm really, really excited. And I'm also I gotta tell you, I'm super excited that the focus seems to be so much on the arts. Because I think when we're talking about unity in this country and how to achieve that, I think art plays a really, really important role in that. And so I'm excited. And I'm also excited about Amanda Gorman, who's my favorite poet ever.
Yes.
And also a friend. I saw her perform live and I was just blown away by everything about that young woman. And so it's something, it's all something to look forward to. And I'm looking forward to just feeling hope again.
Me too.
Yeah.
Me too.
It's the little things that make the big things, right?
That's right. Absolutely.
Well, Yvanna, thank you so much for spending the time being with us. And I appreciate you and everything that you've done for the inauguration and for Biden and Kamala. Thank you so much.
Well, it goes both ways. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. God bless you.
You too. Bye-bye.
Bye. Okay, everybody. So that is a little insider perspective on what we can expect. So again, follow at Biden Inaugural here on Instagram, and you could go to bidenInaugural.org/dayofservice to find events for Monday and to volunteer to celebrate Dr. King's amazing legacy. And that's all I have. Thank you for this incredibly special and memorable Instagram Live. And God bless you all. And let's all watch the inauguration together from our homes in our pajamas with a pint of ice cream. God bless you.